Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. We still want to praise and worship for a little bit? Sure.
Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, your perfect love is casting out fears. And even when I'm caught in the middle of the storms of this life, I won't turn back, I know
this is a good song. You are near.
I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. And if my God is with me, whom then shall I fear? Whom then shall I fear?
Sing it with me! Oh no, you never let go through the fire. Song and it's probably gonna get erased, but that's okay. It's okay because we got a little juicy. We get, watch it, mister. What you doing? Ba ba ba. Okay, God, don't know where you're going. That's such a good song though, but I do not own the rights to that song. It's on the radio, which I thought you kind of own the air rights when you're listening to the radio, but you know, let me just put it out there. It ain't my song. So anyway, so guess what? I'm in such a good mood again because this whole box theory that I gave myself yesterday, and if you missed yesterday's episode, you need to watch that because it's pretty deep. All right, you guys, pretty deep. Yesterday's box theory, pretty deep. So in a nutshell, the box theory is this. So you don't have to watch the show. If you, every day, you give God a gift of what you did the day before. So, not only, well, you give him a gift of the good and the bad. if you know what I mean, okay? So yesterday I was so good. I was very good. I cursed a lot because that's what I do. So I had to put cursing in the box, which God doesn't like dirty talk like that, but I'm working on it. I can't do everything, you know what I mean? So, but at least I'm conscientious of it. Like, you know what I mean? I know what I'm doing. I made dinner. It was absolutely atrocious. I don't know why. Maybe the mushrooms were rotten. I don't know. This crock pot is not my friend. Or maybe the meat was rotten. I have no idea. But couldn't eat it. It was beef stroganoff. Normally that comes out pretty tasty. But, it smelled so horrible. We couldn't eat it. It just smelled so horrible. It just smelled so horrible. And it felt terrible because it was like a pound of meat, I'm thinking. Maybe a half pound. But, yeah, I think it's a half pound because we don't have very many leftovers when I use that. I'm going to have to check it, but it was like $5, okay? And I do feel bad that I wasted it. And anyone who wants to eat the leftovers is more than welcome to come and get it, all right? Because it's a crock pot full of disgusting beef stroganoff. But I don't have any homeless people near me because I would totally give them that because it's not terrible. Like, other people would probably like it, but I'm very particular about my food. That's why I need a chef. Wanted chef. Personal chef. To come to my house, make dinner, and then leave. But I want dinner fresh from my pan. Not like microwave, put it in the oven, I made it at my house. No. I want it fresh made at my house. Number two. I don't even know why I'm talking about that. Probably because I'm hungry all the time. Because all I had for dinner last night was a yogurt. But anyway, I'm trying to lose weight anyway. Because I was dating this guy for like 3 weeks. And I gained so much weight in like 3 weeks. I'm not even kidding. Because I was gluttonous. I had steak a lot. So, who do you talk to about the roads? Who do you talk to about the road? I know who you talk to if your life road is hard. I don't know who you talk to if the city roads are hard to drive on. So, back to the box. So I only put some cursing in the box yesterday. I spent time with the kid, cooked dinner. I was a responsible mom. So these are my goals for every day. Spending time with the kid, cooking dinner for the kid. not drinking. And working on my business plan. Okay? Every day, moving a step forward to that. So today I have to figure out a new recipe to make up for yesterday's monstrosity. So that's me growing as a mom. That's what I'm doing. So, did Bible study this morning. Unfortunately, I was kind of rushed. See, I got a new schedule now, but I'm already, like, not late, but not relaxed like I was 2 days ago when I had a different schedule. Annoying. So anyway, I stress myself out for the craziest things. I should just wake up at 6 o'clock, and that's it. I woke up at 4:30 this morning, because I normally wake up at 5:30. They say wake up an hour earlier and then you'll be successful. An hour earlier than when you wake up. But I don't do anything when I wake up. I just force myself to go back to sleep. So I don't think I'm doing it right. So, I'm focused on my business, which is my ministry. And I don't want to call it a business. It's my ministry. But I have to get back to doing my show, right? So I wanted to just announce that I'm going to be doing my show again. It's 7:30, all right? I'm going to try and go back to every day, 7:30. Because that's when I'm driving, and I know that you guys don't like when I'm driving, because it's not nearly as fun, but it's not about always having fun. It's about learning the word, getting closer to God, and hanging out with me, and seeing that we can cheer that everything's going all right, 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 right. Okay, see, as long as we're on the same page, you guys, we're fine. So, I was given a list from God on a few things that I need to write about. So I'm super excited about that too. I'm getting all of my stuff together. That's what it was. Okay, today's word. I just remembered what it was. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. I missed who it was. But it's time to build the new temple in Jerusalem. So all the people were bringing together all the silver and the gold and all the stuff they had to put towards the temple. And then there was like a big inventory, right? And it was very brief that I read it, and I apologize, I didn't catch the verse. It was right at the beginning of a book. I totally missed the name of the book. It's so bizarre. So if you think about that, everybody's bringing what they have together. And that is similar to what we need to do when we're building our, whatever we're building, whatever we want, whatever God's gift is that he gave us, whether we're a teacher, we're a nurse, we're an encourager, we're a speaker, whatever we are, we have to bring together our inventory, right? Not just the inventory that we have in ourselves, like, okay, I'm a good speaker, I'm a good researcher, but maybe I'm not the most organized. So maybe I have to bring in somebody to help me stay organized, right? So I need to check, because it's a project. So if you think about it, it's like a project manager. You know, you want to think about everything you need, things you might need, things you would love to have, your budget, the people that are going to need to be involved with making the project happen. Say it's building a house. You know, I could be a general contractor, but I need a plumber, an electrician, HVAC guy, drywall man. You know what I mean? You need a lot of different people with a lot of different skills coming together to make that house, right? So God has been so good. Not only has he told me to move forward with what I'm thinking, I'm a speaker for him, I just found an illustrator to make my little cartoon girl. And I've been looking for somebody to do this for like, I think easily three years. And I found her yesterday, so that's awesome. She makes these really cute, wacky little characters I can dig. So, I'm excited about that. Just gonna find out about her hair. Her hair. Can't look like my hair. Her hair. So, today's lesson is basically, when you are trying to put something together, when you're walking in your God-given talent and you're walking in alignment with God, the people will come into your life that need to come into your life. You're gonna see it's weird. It's very weird. People that you didn't know are going to come and give you advice about something that you're like, oh my gosh, thanks so much for that, because that totally like sent me to the next level. So keep your eyes and ears open. Be nice to people. Be kind everywhere you go. Emulate the light of God that he has put inside you, that we are supposed to shine for others. Because when others are lost, they'll be able to find the light. So we have to be the light for them. Time to go. Thanks for watching. My name's Diana. This is Winning with Jesus. If you like my content, you can give me a thumbs up. I'm trying to go a little shorter. Less about me, more about the big G. That's hard. It's normally a 50-50 go. It should be, though, it really should be 1/5. I should be 1/5 of this whole thing. Is it 1/5? No, it's 1/4, Diana. I am such a bonehead. God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit. And then me. So I should be 1/4 quarter. That's for that quarter that I have. 1/5? Oh, my phone's dying. So that's it. Sorry, I started babbling at the end there because I have to drive now. All right. Thank you so much for watching. I love you all. I appreciate you all. Please share. My name's Diana. This is Winning with Jesus. And remember, be blessed to be a blessing.